Good day, YouTube patrons, friends, family, strangers, welcome, one and all, to the Black Tiger Show, or just a video by me, Black Tiger, okay. All right, well, let's get it going on and see what's up in the world today. So, I received an email this morning from Guns America. Pretty good website. They put out a lot of good information in regards to the Second Amendment, and they also have pretty good deals on certain firearms at times, and they have good reviews and such, so if you feel inclined, check out Guns America. I like being subscribed to their emails. But today's topic is relevant to a previous video that I did, because once again, people are proposing to try and violate the Constitution, and I don't believe that they even know it because they haven't read the entire Constitution. Not many people have. I haven't read the entire Constitution. I've read most of it, but you know, there's a lot to it. People just think, well, yeah, the Constitution, the amendments. It's like the Constitution is way more than the amendments. So let's get it started here. We are seeing California lawmaker wants to tax sale of all handguns, semi-automatics. So, introduced as AB 18, the legislation would impose an excise tax on the sales of handguns and semi-automatic rifles and would require the revenue collected from that tax to be used to fund grants through the CalVIP, which is the California Violence Intervention and Prevention Program. Oh, gee, I wonder how effective that is, especially with, you know, illegal immigrants and, you know, that sort of thing and legal residents that are gangbangers and otherwise criminals that don't give a crap about these programs. I fail to see how they're effectual. But I digress. So the bill's sponsor, Assemblymember Marc Levine. Said that his goal is for fewer gun deaths. How this will result in fewer gun deaths, I have no idea. It sounds like he's trying to pass what's otherwise known as a poor tax, making people pay more money for something so that if they, you know, so that way they can't afford it, which is essentially a poor tax. He states the gun tax will support the kind of interventions that make gun violence less likely in the first place, which is exactly what we need to do. I wish he would specify what type of interventions that he's talking about that are supposedly going to make violence less likely, but he doesn't really feel inclined to delve into that too much here, so he did not disclose how much of a tax he would want the legislature to levy, but there's been speculation that it'll be in the $25 range, falling in line with what places like Seattle and Cook County have done in recent years. To this end, the LA Times editorial board came out in favor of the proposal, what a shocker, and they argue that gun owners should shoulder a little more of the cost of gun violence. Okay, so people that aren't at all responsible for gun violence should shoulder the cost of gun violence that they're not responsible for? How about you shoulder the cost of drunk drivers? You know, like, that's just preposterous and ludicrous. You're putting things on people that don't fall on them, you know, so... The Times board said that what we do know is that over the last 5 years, an average of 503,000 handguns have been sold each year. Good. I wish it were a million. As have 556,000 long guns, including hunting rifles, shotguns, and assault weapons. If I pick up a chair and smash it over your head, that's an assault weapon because I'm assaulting you with an instrument that is being used as a weapon. So their term assault weapon is just bogus. And they further, if just handguns had been covered, a $25 tax would have raised $12.6 million per year. If all the guns were covered, that would have raised $26.5 million a year. Hey, I have a suggestion. How about you not try and supplement your bad budgeting by taxing people that aren't doing anything wrong? So, I want to wrap this up and not go too long because I can only record 10-minute videos now through my phone if I want to get good quality because my computer, my two webcams, I can't make good videos all of a sudden one day. You know, it's like all of a sudden I get like 400 subscribers. It's like, oh my gosh, I'm doing good. And then bam, what's that? Your computer, your stuff doesn't work. You can't, it's like, oh my gosh, thanks, you know, whatever is causing this. So why this is wrong and why this is bad, as I said at the start of the video, this harkens back to an issue that I've already covered about the legality of this in the first place from the Constitution. So let's see what the Constitution actually does have to say about this. Now, right here in Article 1, Section 8, it clearly states, "The Congress shall have power to lay and collect taxes, duties, imposts, and excises, to pay the debts and provide for the common defense and general welfare of the United States. But all duties, imposts, and excises shall be uniform throughout the United States." So, if one state has an excise tax on firearms and another state does not have an excise tax on firearms, that is not uniform. So the state which is engaged in that excise tax is engaging in an unconstitutional tax as according to Article 1, Section 8 of the U.S. Constitution. Plain and simple, that is all. And in all honesty, that's all I have to say about this issue. This, I don't want to call him a name, this horribly anti-Constitution, anti-firearm person out in California wants to violate the Constitution because he feels that he's going to make society safer by making legal gun owners pay more money through taxes, which is just straight up wrong. So if you take issue with this, you should call them up and let them know, you know? So we can't just sit around and complain about things that doesn't do anything. We actually have to take action, and for the most part, the action that we are allowed to take legally is to contact our representatives and tell them that what they're doing is wrong and it's not smart and it's un-American, anti-constitutional, and just plain dumb, you know? I'm sorry, I had to. It's just plain dumb. I'm gonna take a drink of tea here. Just warm enough to not burn my mouth. Ah, that's some good oolong. Some Chinese oolong. So yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. Just one more instance of a person trying to pass taxes to take our money when we're doing nothing wrong in violation of the Constitution. So if you liked this video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, you know, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, if you enjoy this sort of content and the other videos I post. Check out the Discord server. You can join that. I'll link it in the video description. And if you still feel inclined, become a patron and donate money. You can give me just $1 a month, and that will make my life so much better. Like, no joke. I need some money here. So. Alrighty. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you have a great one out there. Stay safe. God bless America. Black Tiger. I'm just gonna grab the camera on the video. Wise up.